This letter is dated 17th. This is to inform you that your application for mandatory retirement from public service has been accepted with effect from 8th.
Led by Rashid Sentongo, the IGG officials met with the medics and other support staff at Jinja Hospital after several complaints and reports emerged about the mess at the facility. In the meeting, it was discovered that the hospital director, Dr. Florence Tugumisirize, retired a month ago, but she illegally continued to occupy this office and transact business on behalf of the hospital. Staff at the facility reported to the IGG that Dr. Tugumisirize turned herself into a semi-god, which for some of them, to take leave as she had made the working environment unfavorable for them.
Just requested for leave.
My
recommendation was to put a permanent staff to replace me. I wrote to the director in writing. I'm recommending Okero.
Who is Okero?
The one you thought was better to...
Exactly, to because it's a permanent
staff. Which one is Okero?
Now Okero is in the pharmacy. To my surprise, she instructed me that let an intern be there.
The staff father told the IGG that the hospital automotive lie idle as the hospital director, Dr. Tugumisirize, vanished with their keys and fuel cards.
Who has the fuel cards? So she moves with all the fuel cards?
No. I think the generator fuel card is with system only.
Fuel cards for the vehicles?
Most of the vehicles are packed, and we've been told that all the keys and the fuel cards for most of these vehicles are kept by the hospital director. I believe that this referral hospital should be having a transport officer who should be coordinating issues of transport.
In the meeting, however, Sentongo pinned the health workers for extorting money from the vulnerable patients, an allegation they denied. The medics lamented of the little pay and poor working conditions which hinders their productivity.
The standard of a doctor, give myself as an example, for me to come to the ward on the major ward round, I have to know how many patients do I have on the ward round, okay, what are the critical cases, about 7, what do they have, what is the latest evidence on such patients. You know what I do? I go to the encyclopedias. Good encyclopedias are paid for. Not Google, we go to paid encyclopedias. I can go to up to date. I subscribe 2 million per year.
The people who are admitted here, you really have to have a very solid hand to take a comment. They are too poor. To be sincere, even if you are a briber, it's so difficult to tell you the truth. But I want to acknowledge this. We would even work on them ourselves. To take money for blood, knowing very well that even with blood, that baby is going to die. What conscience do you go with?
While addressing the media after the meeting, Sentongo showed dismay to the deeds of Dr. Florence, who has deliberately refused to hand over office after retirement. He thus ordered the letter to vacate the embattled office in a period of 10 days.
Within 10 days, Dr. Florence Tugumisirize should have left office because the transactions, the payments she's dealing with or she's approving and even the workshops that she's running are quite irregular.
I will not get back to office when that woman is still in office. Simply because those are audit queries on my side.
Sentongo also said that he has reports that there are ghost workers on Jinja Hospital payroll and a lot of mismanagement of funds takes place at the facility.
Absenteeism is the most common form of corruption. And most of the doctors in this referral hospital and on the payrolls in Zambia and Rubaga and even in private clinics in Kampala. So they are rarely on station.
Speaking to us on phone, Dr. Tugumisirize denied allegations against her and termed those pinning her as opportunities.
I haven't signed any transaction since I paid the intern. And that one I got permission from the PS Minister of Health. Who is the one who assigns what? Who recommends people to be appointed accounting officers? Yes. So what they are talking, I don't know, because I'm in my bed in Kampala sleeping.
Story by Ivan Lubega for the news in Jinja.